Hey, what's up, guys? Thank you very much for being an Electreca. I really appreciate that. Now, today, I want us to look at relay contacts, okay? So how do you understand relay contacts? Probably, it may be a problem for you. So if that's the case, then you can hang on here on this video. Now, let us look at these relays. So we have 11 pin relay here, and then we have this is the 8 pin relay. Okay, all right, so we have different types of relay here. Now, how do you understand a relay? Okay, so relay, it has similarities with a contactor, all right, but it has its specific function. Now, relay mostly it used for control purposes only, and also to switch on small, devices, okay? Because if you look at the contact for the relay are not that big. So usually they will take up to probably around 10 amps or if higher, it is 15 amps, okay, contacts here. So if you are supplying a load through relay, eh? So how do you understand the contacts? Okay, so we have an 8-pin relay here, this, and then we have a base 8-pin. Okay, so when you talk about pin, you mean the contacts and then the coil. Okay, so these are 8, but we have 2-4 coil. And then we have here 6 for the contacts. But again, on these 6, we have got 2, which is common. And then the real contact we're using, the one we are switching, these 2 here. So let us put this here. Can put this one back in here. Okay. Then I want to look at here. We have 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we have, this is common. So common would mean because this one is switching between 2 contacts, so it has to be the common. Okay, if you don't put the wire in its right position, for instance if you put a common here on NC, okay, you put a common on NC and then you want NC to work with any O, it won't be possible because this is normally closed. When you close here, open will close and closed will open, and there will be no current here. Okay, so that's why you have to use a common. Okay, because the relay switches between open and close. Okay, that's how it's done. All right, okay, now. The same thing when we come to this, like this is 11 pin. Okay. So 11 pin, you have got 6 here. These are 6 contacts. Okay. And then you have 2 here. This is 9. And then these 2, we have 3. So 6, 3, that's 9. And then here, 11. Okay. So you have these 2 for your supply, and then you have common here. So this is what makes it to be a single pole double throw. Okay, so you will connect your common right here, and then you have here your closed and open here. So if you have your common here, meaning that normally closed, if there is no voltage or any power acted upon the relay, then this contact and this one will be closed, this and this will be open. Okay, now if there is power acted upon here, then this contact and this will be closed. Okay, so if we check on the relay, there are always directions on the relay. Okay, so if you check on this relay, we have got contact 2 and contact 10, which is a coil. So also if you check here, we have 2 and 10. Okay. And the same thing, if we check another 11 pin, 11 base here, we have got 10, 2. Okay. Right here. So if you slot in, this will be your coil. All right. Okay. Now let's demonstrate something here. So, like I've told you, you have got these two contacts as your supply. Okay. So you now your relay will look like this. So you have got, okay, your coil. So this is number 2, and then this is number 10. Okay. And then you have got these contacts here. Okay. So you have got, let's us draw contact here. I will draw a contact here. Okay. So we'll just have this. Okay. So this is linked, meaning it will pull my magnetism. Okay. So right here, you have got here, this is contact 1131. So we say this is contact, this is common, okay? And then this is maybe contact 11. So this is NC, okay? NC, we can look at here, this is 9, and then this is 8. So we can, so we say this is 9. And then this is open, this is the 9, and it is NO. Okay. So this is your coil. Okay. So usually what we do here is these two, they always say these two here are for your coil. So we just need some wires here to demonstrate the connection. Okay. So you see, this is your A1 or A2, or you have put your live wire here. And then because you're supplying the coil and at the same time you're giving the common supply. So if this is your N and then this is your L, then this will be looped here. Okay. So as you supply your coil, this contact will open here and close here, okay, on this NO, as you can, as you have connected this. Okay, so basically that's how relay works. Okay, so you have got like this type of relay. Okay, so what we have to understand is, so you have, this guy is 14 pin here. Eh? So how many pole does this relay have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 pole. So 4 pole, 00. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pole, 00. So the poles are 4. So this is 4 pole. So if we check, this is 11 pin relay. So how many poles are these? So this is 1, 2, 3. This is 11 pin. The poles are 1, 2, 3. Okay. When we check like the 8 pin relay here, so the 8 pin relay will be 2 pole. Okay. 00. All right. So you will know. Same thing here, you have two pole double zero, okay? So you can know whenever you want to use a relay, you can know which kind of relay you want to use, okay? So in some most cases in automation, you require a number of contacts, okay? So instead of having, imagine if, for instance, this is two pole, okay? So if you want to use a two pole and your need will be like, because we said this is 11 pin is three pole. So your need is three pole. Or it could be or more than three pole. So you have two pole here, you have three pole here. Those are five poles. So instead of having these two to eat your space in your control box, you would just use the specific number of poles that you want. Okay, you have two here, you have three here. Or you can simply do this, okay? Here, you have got four pole right here. You have got four pole here, and maybe another four pole. So that's eight pole, and really are not that big, okay? Or this is three pole. So you get another three pole to make it six pole, okay? So it's better to get, you know, what you want depending on your design, okay? So like if this is eight pole and this is two pole, it means that if you only had this type, you'd have four of these for you to have eight pole, okay? But now you have two here. Or you would need to have four, but this is two poles. So you have two of these. And I can demonstrate that. So you look at this. This is four pole, both of them, because each one has two pole. So we're going to use these two. Okay, you supply them independently. But again, you can use this one, okay, because now this is a four pole alone, and then these two is four pole combined. So it depends on what you want. All right. Also, if you only need to use only two relays, okay, there is no need to have all this bulky relay in your circuit, and yet you're going to use only a few contacts. Okay. So basically, that's how you're going to be doing playing around with your relay. Nothing big, no complex. It's just that understanding contacts. Okay. All right. So thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, to like and share. Until next time, I'm out.